Nityanandeshwara Sadashiva Samarambham Nityanandeshwari Adishakti Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam. I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, participants, visitors, viewers, sitting with us all over the world for this program. Experience Kailasa. First of all, I want to tell you, I recommend you take notes. And I also allow anybody to video record, audio record. So all this should make you understand how important this session is going to be. And I also sincerely recommend you watch this like a spiritual practice for next 21 days. I'm going to introduce Mahasadashiva. Everything possible which can be introduced. Dimension or cosmology, understanding, I'll introduce in every possible way. I'm introducing cosmology directly from horse's mouth. Understand? Maybe if we want to use this horse's mouth phrase in a very Indian Shaivite way, bull's mouth, we can change it. Nandi's mouth. Directly. First thing I want to tell you, people feeling, oh, these big concepts, ideas, cosmology, all these are not for me. This idea is not cute. Please understand, Sanatana Hindu Dharma is very clear. Not able to understand is lie. Not interested in understanding is the truth. Listen. The word not able to understand is lie. Not interested in understanding is the truth. So do not cherish with the cuteness. Oh, all these big concepts I don't understand. I don't care. I don't want all these big concepts. You just tell me what should I do. I am telling what you should do. Understand. Now people try to celebrate, feel cute about their decision not to put their listening and integrity together to understand life. Please understand. If you are in this cosmos, You need to understand this cosmos, and you are equipped enough by Sadashiva to understand this cosmos. So all these sentiments, oh, these big, big words, big, big ideas, big, big concepts, I cannot grasp. I am a simple devotee. No. Don't. Being a simple devotee is not alternative to understanding. You will be a simple devotee only if you understand the cosmos, not otherwise. Ignorance is not celebrated in Hindu tradition. Ignorance cannot be the quality of a devotee. Many times I hear this argument, oh Swamiji, I am a simple devotee. You just tell me what should I do. I cannot understand these big, big words, cosmology, cosmos. No. If you are a simple devotee, sit with integrity and your simplicity, you will understand exactly what I am talking and you will experience it now. I am introducing Mahasadashiva as he himself introduces himself in Vidyapada of Agamas, and I have some of the interesting articles by modern day researchers in the modern day. Some people are trying to research from the angle of neuroscience and brain, possibilities of brain and the universe. I have a bunch of resources, a set of articles. I will highly recommend all of you read all these articles today after this session. So please read these articles which I am recommending. You will understand many things in the language you cognize. I am not saying these researchers have grasped everything of what Sadashiva talks about cosmology in the Agamas, what Sadashiva introduces. I don't want to say these researchers have got everything, but I can comfortably say that they are moving in that direction. For example, whatever, let me first give you the reference of those articles. It is like a Science Daily, Science News, Multidimensional Universe in Brain Networks. That's article name, and I have few more, maybe around 20 articles.
This is the second article. The human brain can create structures up to 11 dimensions. And then I'm again projecting a sequence of article titles. The next is multi-dimensional universe in brain networks. You can actually take a screenshot of the screen here. The next is new mathematical method reveals structure and neural activity in the brain. Mathematicians help unlock brain function. Multi-scale computational model sheds light on embryonic development. Cold Spring Harbor dream to use $2.7 million NIH grant to map long-range neural projections. Researchers propose sequencing-based approach to map all neuron connections in the brain.
Now I want to tell you, first I wanted to express my appreciation for these researchers putting their knowledge and intelligence, time, energy and integrity in this line. And I will really recommend to them to spend a little time on Vidyapada of Agama, where the cosmos introduces cosmology. Mahasadashiva talks about cosmology. It will really be wonderful that they will be helped in their research. They will know which direction they should look. Towards which direction they should look. Okay, now all this research is all about your brain. Understand, this is like a mirror. This is the mirror in which the cosmos reflects, and this is the organ. I can't even use the word organ, it is little more than organ. This is the system through which you are perceiving the cosmos, universe, existence. These researchers have done research on what all is being perceived here, means in the reflection. Based on that, they are projecting, assuming, trying to understand what must be there. All of your understanding. This, what is being perceived, reflected in this, is presumed as photograph or reflection of what is out there. So by studying this, what is going on in this, with a very evolved mathematics called algebraic topology. I don't know whether I pronounce the word properly, algebraic topology. Whatever. So with that, they are trying to study, project, understand what is going on in this. With that, they are trying to understand what must be out there. Now, the good news I have for the researchers is you are heading in right direction, because we have a description of what is out there already by the person who is out there. We have description, a very elaborate and very detailed, Bhur, Bhuva, Suva, Tapa, Satya, all the lokas and dimensions. We have description by the person who is out there about what is there. Your algebraic topology, which they are trying to use, which acts like a telescope and microscope together. Understand? Algebraic topology is like a telescope, can project into the space to study the Big Bang and black holes. And it can be microscope, can be zoomed into inside a forest, a python hiding in the hole of a tree, and the blood group of that python, whether that python has some bacterial infection. It is like it can zoom into the networks. Understand, this algebraic topology is a very sophisticated maths they use, which behaves like telescope and microscope together. And with this, they are studying what is happening here. What is happening here? Roughly, I will equate this as a pindanda. And what is happening there is Brahmanda. By studying the pindanda with algebraic topology, researchers are trying to understand multi dimensions of the universe. Listen. Sorry if I am presenting too complicated things. I'll try to map it down to your language and the way you can grasp. Fundamentally, the researchers are trying to convey the various dimensions. 1D means rod, 2D means plank, 3D means cube, and the 4th D is the spatial dimension called time. The scientists are trying to explain through this algebraic topology, which works like a telescope and microscope together. It is not just this 4-dimension alone our brain is perceiving. Our brain is able to perceive higher dimensions, multiple dimensions. Because of that, they come to a conclusion, multiple dimensions exist, because the reflection shows the multiple dimension perceptions, not only the possibility, but as a reality. They are saying that many of this algebraic topology data they have discovered, they try to map it and see its effect on the rat's brain and the researchers are confirming many of this data is very realistic. Understand? This is where I wanted to suggest to them. One, please study Vidyapada of Agamas. You will have lot of input, support and direction. That is one. Second, if you are really interested only in research, if you are not interested in any vested interests, come. You don't need to waste your time on putting your algebraic topology projections, mathematics on the rat's brain and study. I'll give you live brain. You can study mine. I'll reflect this whole 11 dimension. What is out there in here purely? Study all the 86 billion neurons and its activities simultaneously. I am not interested in any of the pride, all these that. I am saying, let's do something good to the world. Not only me, I can recommend and request many of my disciples also to support you in your research. We can live reflect, understand? Scientists are equipped with the algebraical topology which functions like a telescope and microscope together for microcosm, brain, pindanda. We are equipped with third eye penetrated by oneness, third eye opened by oneness, can be used same way algebraic topology is used in microcosm. We can use the third eye penetrated by the oneness in macrocosm. Understand? Scientists with their algebraic topology, which can function like a telescope and microscope together, study the multidimensional happening in the brain. We Shaivites, empowered by Mahasadashiva, whose third eyes are penetrated by the oneness, can show precisely what is out there in here. All of you are able to understand in the macrocosm brain. Algebraic topology helps. Topology helps. Like a telescope and microscope to study what is going on in this. With that only they are coming to many understandings. I am telling them, please come here. We have cosmic algebraic topology, third eye penetrated by oneness, which can function a cosmic telescope and microscope together. I can project and tell you precisely what is happening in the sun now. The precise temperature change or precise happenings of the sun and precisely what is happening in your eardrum when you hear these words from my mouth. Understand? Microcosms, telescope and microscope is algebraic topology. Macrocosms, telescope and microscope together is third eye penetrated by oneness. As long as third eye is not penetrated by oneness, it is not opened, it is not yet initiated. The moment it is initiated, if the third eye is penetrated by the oneness, it acts as telescope and microscope together for cosmos, Brahmanda, what is out there. I can provide two help to these scientists by giving the documentation about what is out there by the person who owns everything out there. It's a owner's document. Who created and who is sustaining his own internal document. That is one. Second, I can provide direction and evidence of whatever is out there by making the pure reflection of that in here. Live human brain, you don't need a rat and rat's brain. We have now enough of powers, empowered human beings who can just through their brain show you precisely what's going on now in Kailasa, what's going on now in Tapoloka, what's going on now in Bhur, Bhuva and Suva, in all the different lokas. Understand, you do not need to use the rat's brain to map the data you collect through algebraic topology and verify them with a reality. We can provide. Not only I am open and many of my disciples whose third eye is penetrated by the oneness. I have not even entered into what I am supposed to share today. I am only introducing the fundamental understandings. Sanatana Hindu Dharma is rich man's religion. Means who is really rich in everything. It is not created to control the mass with certain ideas and concepts and like a mental prison. No. This Dharma teaches you mind is a prison. So it never was generated. So whatever I shared now, I'll give you the essence in few lines. What is out there reflects here. Some of the scientists and researchers who are studying the reflection have found the reference. What is out there is not just four dimension, at least 11 dimension. And the methodology they used, algebraic topology, and the informations they have, they even tried to map it down on the brain of the rat and confirming many of the informations they have makes sense. So I am giving them my support in two ways. You are only working on what is reflecting here. Unfortunately, a normal brain's reflection is not complete. That's first. Second, we actually have a documentation of what is out there by the owner who is out there. And it is available in here. We can provide you the documentation. Next to the documentation, we can provide you a live laboratory where you can see the reflection, a pure reflection of what is out there in here, to take your researches further. So you can try to understand what is in here and what is out there, Pindanda and Brahmanda. Like your algebraic topology, which can function as a telescope and microscope together for பிண்டாண்ட ரிஃப்ளக்ஷன். அவர் ஒன்னஸ் ஃபில்டு தேர்ட் ஐ கேன் பி யூஸ்ட் அஸ் அ டெலஸ்கோப் அண்ட் மைக்ரோஸ்கோப் டுகெதர் ஃபார் த பிரம்மாண்ட காஸ்மாஸ். யூ ஹாவ் அ லைவ் டெலஸ்கோப் மைக்ரோஸ்கோப் டுகெதர் ஃபார் காஸ்மாஸ். The live telescope, microscope together for cosmos is inviting you all to support you all in further researches you want to do on this 11 dimensions aspect. So with this, let me start the program. I started the program saying I am going to introduce Mahasadashiva. I only prepared you to introduce Mahasadashiva. I need to convince you why such complex understandings about cosmos and life need to happen. Understand? If you have complex understandings, you will not have complex problems. If you don't have, and if you are avoiding complex understandings, you will have complex problems. Decide whether to put your energy towards the understanding and problem-free life, or avoid putting energy towards understanding and live with problems. In any field, if you want to be successful, you need to put little your time and energy to understand the logic of that field. Even to operate a cell phone, you need to pick up the cell phone, understand where is the number, how to press and all that, and where to keep. You can't keep it somewhere and talk. You have to keep it in your ears and near the mouth. Now you need to understand the logic. So if you want to understand and manifest the powers, want to experience Kailasa, you need to decide, you should understand Kailasa. You can't say, oh, I am an innocent devotee and I am a simple person. Just no. Your ignorance is neither cute nor welcome. And you are not created for ignorance. Be very clear. Be very clear. All you need is your decision to complete with the pattern of celebrating your ignorance as cute. As if something right, as if it's okay. No, it's not okay. It's not okay. Seeker is a person who is trying to understand cosmos. So you have to understand cosmos. You can't say, I want to go to Kailash, I want to experience Kailash, I want to understand the whole cosmos, I want to manifest all the powers, but I am very innocent, little ignorant, very innocent, old devotee. That's not cute. That's not cute. Complete with the pattern of celebrating ignorance, because I am going to introduce some of the very important truths of life. We need to understand cosmos because we are working and living, functioning in the cosmos. Making it as simple as possible and mapping it in such a way, your inner space grasps it, experiences it, is my job. That is my job. I will do it. But not even interested in entering, holding my hand to come along with me is not right. So hold my hand and come along with me. It means sit with integrity and listening and come along with me. I'll take you to Kailash now. You need to understand Kailash Pati, Lord of Kailash, Mahasadashiva. Only then you can experience Kailasa. It is actually a beautiful painting here. I am showing, projecting a painting of Mahasadashiva. It is a traditional painting done as per the introduction of Mahasadashiva. About his cosmic form, in a way we can understand. Originally he says thousands of heads and thousands of hands, means literally all the identities exist, is part of him. All the heads exist, is part of him, whether it works or not. You may ask, even mine? Yes, yours, even yours. That's a good news. Even yours is. Here it is presented with a 25 head in a very symbolic way. Can you project that? Understand, in the first means the lowest row, which is connected to the neck. 9 heads are there. In the next row, 7 heads are there. In the further row, 5 heads are there. And further, 3 heads are there. Then further, 1 head. It's a symbolic representation. And I wanted to tell you all, I am giving you only very minimal understanding which is required for you to experience Kailasa. It's like if you go to Universal Studio or Disney World, Disneyland, how they give you a very minimal introduction to let you experience and enjoy all the rides and shows and the place. Same way, I am only giving you a very minimal introduction. I am not torturing you with too much information. No. I am trying to make everything user friendly as much as possible. As much user friendly as possible. The A row of the heads connected to his neck. Nine faces. Is mathematics of the universe lesson. Mathematics of the logic and mathematics of the universe is different. Mathematics of the logic is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Number 1 plus 1 is 2. When you do this addition, subtraction, it is all whether the work or the result is only in your logic. For example, like a paper. If you put 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, that is only in the paper. But the cosmic mathematics is the actual dimensions. Like when I say the first phase, it is not equivalent to mathematical 1. It is a cosmic 1, means the first dimension of the universe, length. Is not mathematical 2, which exists in logic. It is second dimension, Planck. First dimension can be called as a rod, just one dimension. Then Planck, second dimension, means length and breadth together. Three is third dimension, the length, breadth, depth together. Listen, I think many of you are seeing new me. Who is after the length, breadth, depth, the four, in the fourth phase only sound even starts. Understand? The science says any particle's movement creates sound. Sadashiva says very clearly, if the particle moves only in the length, breadth, depth, sound is generated. If it moves only from length to length, no sound is generated. Listen. You may say, oh, my hand, if I move like this, sound is generated. Very subtle. It is generated because your hand has a depth. This or this does not generate sound. Atom, molecule moving this way or just this way does not generate sound. If it moves only this way or that way or this way, where the depth is involved, sound is generated. So only after the third dimension, Sadashiva, Mahasadashiva introduces nada, sound. This information is very important for you because the mathematical 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is not cosmical 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In mathematical 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, after 3, suddenly you cannot introduce something extra. 1, 2, 3, it has to be 4. Cannot be 4 and half. That is mathematical, numerical. But in cosmical, 1, 2, 3, 3 and half, 4. I don't even want to say 3 and half. 3, something more than 3 and 4. I don't even want to say it is between 3 and 4, no. Because after the 4, that what came in between is getting added as a load on the 4. That is why, understand, in the 7-9 phase, only after the 3rd phase the upper phases are sitting. Means now no more the phases are linear, they are multidimensional. Listen, 9 phase. 1st phase length, 2nd phase breadth, 3rd phase depth. Now in the depth, sound comes as a new introduction. So after the sound is introduced, it is no more 3rd to 4th, 3rd with one more head on the top and 4th. And the 4th has 2 more heads on the top and 5th. 5th has 3 more heads on the top and 6th. How many of you are catching it? Understand? The depth no sound. After the depth, when the sound is introduced, 4 is not just like how from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. No. 1 to 2 is 1 to 2. 2 to 3 is 2 to 3. But 3 to 4 is not 3 to 4. 3 plus something and 4. Listen. In the depth starts happening sound. How many of you are grasping what I am saying? You see, you need to understand this, because when you explore you will manifest so much. I tell you, all values come when you know you are a valuable person. That is why it is value. In Tamil, Nanayam, Tan Nanayam Therindhal Dhan Varum. If you know your value, your worth, only then you will manifest values in life. You will not give up your integrity for 2 pennies lying on the ground. No. You know your integrity is much more valuable than that penny lying on the ground. So you need to understand. Listen. Now, length, the first head, second head, breath, third head, depth, fourth head, time, but it is not just like how we moved from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, it is not same 3 to 4, because in the 3, suddenly one thing is added, one head on the top, that is nada, sound. And sound cannot come just in y-axis travel or x-axis travel. All sound is generated only in z-axis travel. Any particle, pure movement of x-axis and y-axis. I don't know whether I showed properly. I think this is x-axis, and this is y-axis. Listen, pure movement of x-axis and y-axis of a particle does not generate sound. It is z-axis, z-axis, that travel generates sound. So, when it comes from length to breadth to depth, it is not directly from depth to time you can jump. Now you need to consider one more dimension of life, nada, sound as introduced. Sound has come into existence. So the time is going to be handled. Time is going to be the totality of not just 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 plus the sound. Totality of this 4 is the 4 time, fourth head. Now, fifth head, listen, fifth head is connected to the body. The neck is the integrity, poison is the non-integrity. It is integrity connects the Sadashiva with the whole universe, universe with Sadashiva. Anybody with integrity can penetrate Alahala and connect with Sadashiva and all his dimensions and live. When you miss integrity, you cannot penetrate the Alahala. Listen, first head, length. That's a face. I'm purposely explaining with just as per the Agama's introduction, because I don't want this knowledge to be stolen by the people and mapping it back to their understanding and saying Agama has been written much later than the science discovery. Nowadays, in the modern day, that one big crime is going on. Steal everything Vedic. And then say that Vedas were written very recently after all the modern day discoveries. Some pandit who did not have a job, he read all the English books and he translated everything in Sanskrit and made a book. That's what they are trying to claim. The Vaimanik Shastra was written very recently by somebody mapping all the Western concepts of aeronautics into Sanskrit. Okay. So that is the reason I am presenting it with the original visual map as it is. See, the first phase, length. Second phase, breadth. Till then, those heads are just independent. Nothing much above on them. You see, here they have put it like a tower. But actually, when Sadashiva Mahasadashiva introduces himself, he says after the third head starts the on the third head starts the next dimension. Means 7, when it is put on 9, only on the third the next starts. Am I right? All of you understanding? All of you are catching it? So the third is the depth. In the depth is what? Nada. The sound starts. That is above head. The head which is above the third head. I don't want to say fourth head. Because the fourth head is next head only is going to have the title fourth head. All of you are catching what I am saying? Above the third head, which is the side effect of 1, 2, 3, is sitting. Which is sound, nada. Above the fourth head, two heads are sitting. Listen. Above the fourth head, which is kala, sound, listen very carefully. Sound and nada and bindu. Bindu means longevity, life. Only when the time is introduced, longevity concept gets introduced. Till the time is introduced, there is no life, longevity. How many of you are grasping? So the head sitting on the fourth, one is time, nada, bindu, above, which is this. See, the fourth, nada, bindu. That is life. Only the time dimension in, see, the depth dimension introduces sound in the cosmos. Time dimension introduces sound and life, longevity. Kala is kala kala. Kala is life and death. Am I able to make you all understand? The fifth head, listen. The fifth head is what is connected to the body. Body is the universe. All these heads are units, identity. Understand? Your identity is the unit of your consciousness. If your consciousness, listen, all the identities with which you play as a father, mother, brother, sister, son, daughter, victim, aggressive, all your identities put together is your consciousness. How many of you understand that? That is your world. Here, each head is the unit. Each head is the identity. All these identities put together is universe. Sadashiva, Mahasadashiva. Like all your identities put together is your consciousness. Identity is used as a unit to measure your consciousness. If you are entertaining more unit of father identity, that will be the lifestyle of your consciousness. If you are entertaining the beloved identity more units, that will be major aspect of your life. So measurement of your life, who you are, the jivatma, pratyagatma chaitanya is done by the units of your identity. For example, if I have to write a formula about you, 7-unit father, 8-unit mother, 3-unit being a son, 4-unit being a brother, and 1-unit of being a charitable person, 2-unit of being a beggar, and 7-unit of victim, and 8-unit of courageous person. Identities you use is the unit with which formula about you can be written. How many of you are grasping this statement? Now, the identities of Sadashiva is the unit of the cosmos. See here, first phase is length, second phase is breadth, third phase is depth. But the depth does not just keep quiet as depth. If it is mathematical 1, 2, 3, it should be just 1, 2, 3. But it is not mathematical, it is existential. One man plus one woman mathematically is 2 person, but existentially there will be 3rd child. If you allow both of them to be there, there will be child. So existential mathematics is different from your logical mathematics. When the 3rd dimension of the depth happens, I don't want to say 4th dimension, the next thing of a sound happens existentially. And next phase, when the next phase is added, this is time. When the time is brought into the scene, nada and bindu both are added. That is nada and bindu. Yes. You may say, why nada should be added to depth and time? When the bindu is added, nada is no more an ordinary nada. Sound which is not created never dies. Sound which is created dies. Sound which happens only with the association of length, breadth, depth can die. But the sound which happens with the association of length, breadth, depth, time and space does not die. So the sound associated just length, breadth, depth is different. And the sound associated to length, breadth, depth, time and space is different. Just the sound generated by length, breadth, depth. Like I am moving this. This sound is different than the length, breadth, depth, time, all 4 create certain sound that is different. I'll give you the example. The sound generated by the 2 objects hitting, it is between length, breadth, depth and time. But the sound generated by my inner space, where length, breadth, depth, time and space is also involved, this can create the same space I am in you. But this sound cannot create the same space it is in you. How many of you are grasping? So the head which is sitting on the depth can only be called as Shabda. Head which is sitting on the time between the Bindu is called Nada. Shabda cannot create effect, it can only exist. It can survive, not reproduce. Impotent man. He can exist, he cannot create. But Nada can exist and create because Bindu is added, life is added into it. A sound potent of producing something in you is Nada. Sound impotent of making any impact on the universe is Shabda. Then comes combination of length, breadth, depth, time, space as the fifth head. Above that sits Nada, Nation, Bindu, Amaratva, immortality. Above sits Nada, Bindu and immortality, Amritatva. Tattva means unit. Amritatva. In this dimension only, the gods and goddesses who don't get into non-existence live. So from here, there can never be a non-existence. There can only be the transformation, but no non-existence. We may think, why do we need to know all this? If you know these basic understandings, you can map them in your life in multiple level, and it can strengthen your balance sheet. Understand? It can make you healthy, wealthy, happy, blissful, because many of these understandings awakens those dimensions of your brain. Already, if you are feeling too much is happening in your brain, raise your hand. Good. Those electrical signals, understand? When the owner is introducing his home and you are sitting in front of him, his neurons, brain neuron activity mirrors in your brain. Bindu is life, Amritatva is life, which cannot be dulled, reduced, diluted by length, breadth, depth, time, kala kala. Amritatva is the space on which time does not have a say. A cloth, even if you lock it inside a vacuum box for 10 years and then take it out again, you will see it has already withered. No weather would have operated on it, but time operates on it. If you do not allow the time to operate on you, you don't die. If you don't remember you are aging, you will not be aging. That's the truth. Remembrance of aging ages you. The number of time you remember you are aging makes the aging effects on your system. Sadashiva gives an instruction in Agama. Remember, Sadashiva is ever 16, and remember you are he. In those days, that 16 is something like a peak health and peak possibility. Even if you are brought up in a Gurukul way of life, by 16 you will manifest all the powers. So that is the reason that 16. Now, length, breadth, depth, time, space, all these are called dimensions of universe. The shabda, which is byproduct of depth, nada and bindu, which is byproduct of time, nada bindu amrutatva, it's called amrita kala. These things, these heads above, they are called multi dimensions of the universe. Understand? You cannot call Shabda as the fourth dimension of universe. No. Third multi-dimension of the universe is Shabda. Fourth multi-dimension of the universe is Nada Bindu. Fifth multi-dimension of the universe is Nada Bindu Amritakala. How many of you are understanding the statement? First dimension is first dimension. Second dimension is second dimension. Third dimension is not third dimension. Third multi-dimension. Because with the third, the new dimension of Shabda is introduced. Which cannot be called as dimension because we are using the word dimension for fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Third multi-dimension is, see, for example, the third multi-dimension depth has length, breadth, time and depth all together, sorry, not time, length, breadth, shabda and depth together is third multi-dimension. You should know why our masters describe gods with multiple heads. Fools are those who criticize the forms of our Hindu gods, who do not know the universe. They say, why so many heads, so many hands? You don't know. You know only handicapped persons. You do not know multi-handed persons. You know only headless chickens. You do not know multi-headed beings. Third multi-dimension holds length, breadth, depth and shabda. The fourth multi-dimension holds length, breadth, depth, time, nada and bindu. I do not want to use the word, same word, shabda for nada, because nada with quality of life is no more shabda. For example, shabda can be called as a raw precious metal you have. Nada is like a, you sold that metal and have a currency, cash in your hand, which is more active and useful and available for you. Shabda is raw, nada is refined. And when it comes to the next space, space multidimension, there that nada also I don't want to call as nada, nada kala. It is no more just nada, it's nada kala. It is not only the cash you have, it has become an object or a product what you want to have directly. It's like a 3D printer. Out of nada kala, you can just directly do 3D printing of anything you want. Above the nada kala is bindu kala. Above the bindu kala is amrita kala. The qualities, units, understandings about this multidimensional universe as two important use. One, please understand, all of you are now going to meditate. What meditate? Going to remember your original Svabhava Swarupa of Mahasadashiva. I am not just introducing me, I am introducing you to you. I do not talk to anybody who is less in my stature. Understand? This science is called Rajavidya, means a king does not talk to somebody who is less than his stature. This Vidya cannot be taught to somebody who is less than my stature. If I am teaching you, understand, you are same of me. The moment you decide to learn, you are same of me. I have a Shastra Pramana where Mahadeva Sadashiva, Mahasadashiva says, eternal age of 16 years. That's a beautiful word he is telling. He is not saying the 16 which comes after 15 or before 17, he says eternal age of 16. If he says meditate me as 16, you may think before 17 and after 15, that's 16. No. Just pick up the 16 and freeze it into eternity. That is why he is using the word eternal age of 16 years. The quality of the 16 should be absorbed and frozen into eternity. Let me read out the original verse for all of you. Panchasyam dasador tandam spatigabam trilochanam shantam chandrakala chutam sarpasannada satchatam mantrasimhasanasinam Svetapatmo paristitam, paristitam kundalaihi karanai haraihi katistutro darabantanaihi keyuraihi katai kaischaiva channa virais samut samyutam shodasa yutam kantam suprasannam smitananam sulam parasu katkancha vajram vagnim chadakshini abayam pasamanyancha kantam nagan kusautata vamahasta katam dhyayet anyatacha nigatyate prasalpaya katvanka shakti stulastu savyata vame damaru sarpaksha malendivara purakaihi. Eternal 16 means the 16 which comes before 15, after, sorry, before 17, after 15, has its innate quality of becoming 17. He does not want the 16 which will become 17. He says the 16 should be picked up and made it into eternal. All right, let me come back now to understand length is the dimension of universe. Breadth is the dimension of the universe. Depth is multi-dimension of the universe, not dimension of the universe. How many of you are grasping? Length is the dimension of universe. Breadth is the dimension of universe. Depth is multi-dimension of the universe. Time is the multi-dimension of the universe. Space is multi-dimension of the universe. I have just introduced this understanding called multi-dimension. And what is multi-dimension? The essence of this almost 2 hour session is multi-dimension. The purpose of introducing this is two. One, if you understand, great, you can sit as this understanding Mahasadashiva. If you don't understand, your confusion is one of the dimension. Sit with that. Whatever I understood is one, half understood is one head, and completely not understood is another head. Let me sit with all these heads. All non-understood is avyakta, unmanifest to you. And if you decide to make that as part of you and feel that as part of you, it will start revealing itself to you. Anything which you decide as make it as part of you, even if it is good or bad to you, understood or ununderstood, it will reveal its secrets to you. If you keep something as evil or ignorant as outside, you will be God. If you decide to keep that also as part of you, you will become Godal Sadashiva. If you decide to keep something as ignorant away from you, you are a Deva. If you decide to have that also as part of you, even though it does not reveal its secrets to you or friendly with you, you are Mahadeva. That is why Only Mahadeva is worshipped by devas and asuras both. Good and evil both worships Mahadeva. He gives boon to Indra and Ravana both. You are going to meditate, contemplate, internalize, do dhyana on all these great truths. That is why I am introducing all this to you. These understandings are only called as somarasa in tradition, Indo-tradition. So when they enter into your system, you experience Kailasa. You feel real high. With alcohol, you feel high, but you fall down. With somarasa, you feel high and you fly high. With alcohol, everything will look very tall and big because you are on the ground. With somarasa, everything will look small and down because you are on the high. Small break, then we will continue. Let's gather for next session to internalize Mahasadashiva more. Be blissful. Let's gather for next session. Thank you. Be blissful.